Hey, this is Peter from Nextend. The before-after layer has arrived at Smart Slider. In today's video, I'll tell you all you need to know about this cool new effect. This layer gives you the opportunity to show the comparison of two images. By moving the divider, your website's visitors will be able to take a look at the before and after state of your photos. It's important to say that this is a layer, which means that it was made to be a part of the content. You don't necessarily need to have a before and after image to use this layer. In fact, you can use it to compare the colored and monochrome version of your images as well. So there are a lot of great designs you can use it for, which can take your website to a higher level. Let's take a look at the available settings of the before-after layer. To add the new before-after layer, enter the slide you'd like to edit and open the Add Layer panel. You can find the before-after layer at the Special section. Put it down into your slide. The most important options of this layer are the before and after image fields. This is where you can pick your photos for the before-after effect. Then, if you would like to, you can have a label on these images that describes them. These labels have multiple settings. For example, you can choose their positions. There is one more text option you can find lower, which is the caption. Unlike the labels, the caption is constantly displayed on top of the images, so the divider won't hide it the way it hides the labels. I'll turn this option off, as I won't need a caption. If you want to change the typography of the font, you just switch to the Style tab. Here you can choose whether you want to modify the labels or the captions font. For example, you can make the labels bold. Let's go back to the Content tab to check out the next settings. The direction of the divider doesn't have to be horizontal, but it can be vertical as well. For this design, I prefer the horizontal display. By default, you can move the divider by dragging it, but it can automatically follow the cursor if you like that better. There are more arrows to choose from, such as the circle arrow. But you can use a simple line as well. This is all about the before-after layer. I hope you liked it. If you did, leave a like, and if you would like to see more videos in the future, subscribe. Have a nice day.